Good morning. In the previous class, we have seen regarding the admittance form, impedance form of your power system, primitive power system network, so that we can easily analyze the network for finding out the bus impedance matrix and bus admittance matrix. Now we have seen the impedance form. Now let us see the admittance form of the power system, primitive power system network, so that it will be easy for us to analyze the bus admittance matrix. So to get the admittance form of the primitive network, now again let us consider a simple network which is connected between admittance form . So let us see the a simple network which is having an admittance value of admittance value of y. Let the network is having an admittance value of y, and since it is connected between T and Q terminals of the network, so this is a small network which is a part of the large network. So in this network, it is connected between P and Q terminals. So between these two terminals, your network is connected, and the current that is passing into this network is taken as PQ, and Y is the admittance of the network. And let this admittance is being energized by a source of JPQ. At this point, only this admittance is being energized by a source of JPQ. So this is your IPQ and this is your JPQ. And now at this point, the current inside your network is IPQ plus JPQ. Current inside the network is IPQ and as well as your JPQ. And the voltage drop across the complete network, let this be the voltage drop complete across the network, is taken as VPQ. Now, the current inside is IPQ plus JPQ. Now, let us write the KCL equation. What is it? KCL equation. Applying KCL to loop. To this loop, I just wanted to apply KCL equation, which is having a current of IPQ plus JPQ, which is to the admittance of YPQ. Now, whenever we are applying KCL, KCL is nothing but sum of incoming currents is equal to the sum of outgoing currents. So, what are the currents that are entering into the node at this node? The sum of entering currents to the admittance is IPQ plus JPQ. IPQ plus JPQ. And what are the currents that are leaving? What are the currents leaving at the node? Even if the node is nothing but your admittance value of current admittance value. So admittance value of the current is admittance into your voltage drop. Okay. So it is VPQ. VPQ is the voltage drop at this admittance, and the admittance value is YPQ. Into YPQ. This is your KCL equation. KCL equation for the network connected between P and Q terminals. For the network connected between P and Q terminals, this is your KCL equation for only one network. If we are considering this instead of this one single network, if we are considering for the whole power system, so for the whole power system, there may be n number of buses. There are many number of buses. So for that n number of buses, this IPQ and JPQ, instead of IPQ and JPQ, I have to represent it as a matrix, in the form of a matrix. So in that matrix representation is nothing but this IPQ. I can write it as I plus J ith current of the bus and jth current, complete bus matrix of jth bus matrix of the current is equals to V into Y. So from this equation, it is easier to find out the value for Y. So from this, we can get the value for the Y bus. This is nothing but voltage at all the voltage bus matrix, voltage bus matrix, and this is jth current of your bus. And it means all the sources, if you are adding up, if you are representing in the form of a matrix, it is your jth matrix. And ith matrix is nothing but your all the currents entering in the node in that particular network. So that is your ith bus. I plus J matrix is equals to V bus into Y bus. So using this equation, this is your primitive net. Primitive is nothing but the basic standard equation. From this equation, we are going to find out the value for the, or we can determine the value for the Y bus from the equation. So this is your very, very important primitive admittance form. Primitive admittance form. Now, we will next see how to derive the Y bus equation from this primitive admittance form. From the primitive admittance form, how to derive the equation for the Y bus, we are now going to analyze. So, right, Y bus determination of Y bus. So, to determine Y bus, we are having two methods to determine Y bus. One is direct inspection method. And the other one is singular transformation method. So we will see one method after the other method to find out the value for the Y bus. So firstly, let us see the Y bus derivation from the formula. From this formula, let us see the Y bus derivation. That method from which from the primitive admittance form, if we are deriving the Y bus equation, then that method we are calling it as a singular transformation method. So, determination of Y bus, firstly we will see using singular transformation method. This is obtained by, from, it is obtained from, this is obtained from primitive admittance form. Primitive admittance form of power system. So what is the primitive admittance form of the power system? We have to get the equation. What is the last equation? Last equation is I plus J is equals to V into Y. Y. This is our last equation from the primitive admittance form. So, from this primitive admittance form, let us derive the equation. So, let this be your first equation, and we know that bus incidence matrix. We know the bus instance matrix. From the bus instance matrix, bus instance matrix is nothing but the incidence of the vertex to the instance of your element to the vertex. That means is it the matrix which is representing, which is giving you the relationship between your nodes and vertices, sorry, nodes and elements of your network. That means if the element is connecting into the is coming to the node or is moving away from the node, so the relationship is being explained by using this bus incidence matrix. And from the bus incidence matrix, we know that the equation from bus incidence matrix is So from the bus incidence matrix, we know it is equals to V is equals to A into V bus. This is your second equation. Okay. So that means your voltage across your all your buses is equals to the bus incidence matrix into voltage. Voltage is equals to bus in this multiplication. If you see, you will be getting the value for the voltage, complete voltage that is present inside your bus. So now substitute this in this equation. I plus J is equals to Y bus Y into A of V. So now let us pre-multiply on both sides by A transpose. So now this equation is being considered in this form, are being transformed in this form. A transpose into I plus A transpose into J is equals to A transpose into Y into A into V bus. That means on both the sides we are multiplying with a term called A transpose into I. What is A transpose into? A transpose is nothing but transpose of your bus incidence matrix. We are multiplying on, you see, this is your bus incidence matrix that is represented by A. So yeah, on the both sides, we are multiplying by, pre-multiplying by a variable called A transpose is nothing but your transpose of the bus incidence matrix. Okay. Now, we know that what is I? I is all the current, it is a matrix representing all the currents that are present in your network. So, from the KCL, we know that sum of all the currents present in your network is equals to zero. So, that whenever anything multiplied by zero is always equals to zero. Now, substitute it here. Whenever we are substituting, it is equal to zero plus A transpose into J is equal to A transpose Y into A into V bus. A transpose Y into A into V bus. Okay, so this is nothing which can be represented as A transpose into J is equal to A transpose Y A into V of bus. Okay, now this A transpose into J is nothing but it is the multiplication of transposition matrix, transposition of bus incidence matrix into, what is this J? J is the all the matrix which is representing all the source currents, right? What are the source currents that are present in your network? The matrix representation of all the source currents is A transpose into J. So I can write it as J bus, which is equals to A transpose Y into A V into V of bus. So from the earlier representation, from this earlier representation, which is nothing but current matrix is equals to voltage matrix into bus admittance matrix. So from this we can get the value for which we are comparing this, let this be third equation, comparing your third equation and first equation, you can get the value for Y bus as A transpose into Y into A. So this is the equation for the Y bus. So from this equation we can easily derive the Y bus equation. So Y bus is equals to A transpose into Y into A. Now what is this A and A transpose? A is the bus incidence matrix. A is the bus incidence matrix. Okay. A is the bus incidence matrix, and A transpose is the transpose of the interchanging of rows and columns in the bus incidence matrix. We get the A transpose value. And what is this Y? Y is the primitive bus matrix or primitive admittance matrix. Primitive admittance matrix. And in the further classes, we will see how to derive the value for the hour, how to use this equation of Y bus, and how to derive the formula, how to solve a problem using this equation. So the final equation, how to derive the Y bus using singular transformation method, is using this formula. Y bus is equal to A transpose Y into A. This is very important formula, which is the basic formula where we can analyze, or where we can analyze a network, a complete network, for Gauss-Seidel method or Newton-Raphson method or fast decoupled method or decoupled method. We will be using the base formula is this Y bus formula. Y bus is equal to A transpose into Y into A, where A transpose and A are nothing but bus incidence matrices, and Y is nothing but the primitive admittance form of the network, which we have seen in the earlier classes. Okay, so here we have seen this concept, and in the next class we will see how to derive the equation for the Y bus using direct inspection method. Okay.